फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम बैक। टुडे इन दिस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट फर्स्ट ऑर्डर एंड हायर डिग्री ऑर्डिनरी डिफरेंशियल इक्वेशन। सो लेट अस सी द फर्स्ट ऑर्डिनरी डिफरेंशियल इक्वेशन ऑफ फर्स्ट ऑर्डर एंड हायर डिग्री एंड इट्स काउंटर एग्जाम्पल। सो लेट अस सी दैट द डीवाई बाय डीएक्स रेज टू पावर 2 इज इक्वल एक्स स्क्वायर प्लस 1। व्हाई इट इज नोन एज द this kind of form first order and higher degree, that you can see only first derivative is there, so therefore we can say first order is there, and higher degree, that means we have the more than one, therefore this is what first order and higher degree differential equation. So it is known as non-linear differential equation. So in that case, whenever we have this kind of these non-linearity, so how we can solve? So in that case, there are such a method that we are going to discuss in this topic. So let us see another question, that x square p square plus 3xy p plus 2y square is equal 0. So here also you can see that p is nothing but dy by dx. So that is what, it has the degree 2, therefore this is the what, first order and higher degree differential equation. So general form of first order and higher degree differential equation, ordinary differential equation can be written as f of x y p is equal 0. Mind where that the p is equal what? P is nothing but dy by dx, that thing we will keep in mind. So let us see that there are three cases of such equations. Whenever we have that the differential equation of the first order and first higher degree, so in that case we have the three different cases, and in that case we can solve. So let us see the first equation solvable for p, then the equation solvable for y, and equation solvable for x. So we will discuss all these things, but in this particular video we are going to focus on equation solvable for p. So here let us see the equation solvable for p. So let us assume that p raised to n plus p1, p raised to n minus 1 plus p2, p raised to n minus 2 plus and last pn is equal 0. So this is our differential equation with the higher degree. So that degree you can consider that the degree is nothing but n. So this is the ordinary differential equation with the first degree and first order and n degree, where p is nothing but dy by dx. And whatever we have, that the p1, p2 and pn are functions of x and y. Now next, what to do? So the equation 1 is solvable for p. Just look at here, that this equation 1 is solvable for p, then the LHS of equation, that means whatever we have, this part, this is the LHS part, can be resolved in n rational factors of the first degree. That means we can write as a factorization form p minus f1 of xy, p minus f2 xy, p minus f3 of xy, and last p minus fn of xy equal to 0. That means we have converted into factorization form. Now this means what? This factor can be 0, this factor also can be 0. At last, we can also assume that p minus fn of xy is equal 0. This factor is equal 0, that means we can find its solution using that the variable separable method or whatever we have, that the first order and first degree differential equation that we have learned. So using that, we can find f1 of x, y, c is equal 0. Why we are assuming that the only c? Because this is the general solution, and this differential equation, that p is nothing but dy by dx. So we can say it has the order 1. And therefore, if order is 1, so its solution must have its only one constant, arbitrary constant. So therefore, we can say this is f1 of x, y, c is equal 0. But here we have that the different factors, so we can write as a generalization form fi of x, y, c is equal 0, where I is equal 1 to and last n. So where c is the arbitrary constant. So therefore, if I talk about the particular solution of this equation, so it will be what? F1 of xyc into f2 of xyc into at last fn of xyc is equal 0, and that will be the what? Exactly general solution. Now let us look at the question number 1. So this is Given that, solve x square is equal 1 plus p square, where p is equal dy by dx. But now I'm just mentioning that it is solvable for p. Or otherwise, they may ask solve for p. X square is equal 1 plus p square. This example also can solve for x also. So let us see that the p square is equal x square minus 1. So this can be written as p is equal plus or minus square root of x square minus 1. But p is nothing but dy by dx. So you can write this way. Now it is very easy because we have that the variable separable method is there. So we can apply it. So just take dx on the right hand side. So we have this one. Now integrating on the both the side. So integration dy is equal plus or minus integration square root of x square minus 1 dx. Now we have that the standard formula that the integration of the square root of x square minus a square is there. So according to that formula, we can write this final solution. But when I multiply plus or minus insert this bracket, so what I'm just going to get, so plus or minus x by 2 square root of x square minus 1, and now look at here, that is a plus minus, that will be the minus, and minus minus, so it will be the plus. So I have written that minus or plus 1 by 2 log of x plus square root of x square plus 1 plus c, where c is nothing but arbitrary constant, which is the general solution. Now let us look at the next question. Solve p square minus 9p plus 18 is equal 0, where p is equal dy by dx. So this is a non-linear, that you can understand that the degree is nothing but more than 1. So how to solve this example? So let us first write is a factorization form. So can I write that the p square, but here you can assume that 18 is there, so I can write that the minus 6p minus 3p plus 18 is equal 0. Whenever I take the product of this one, so it will be the what? Product of first and last, and its addition will be what? Minus 9p. That means it is okay. Now you can see that the p common from the first two terms. So we have the p into p minus 6, and here you can write 3 common. So you will have p minus 6 is equal 0. So whenever I consider this one, so what I will get? P minus 6 is the common factor, and then P minus 3 is equal 0. What does it mean by P minus 6 is equal 0? Or we can say that the P minus 3 is equal 0. So let us see here, P is nothing but dy by dx is minus 6 is equal 0. So what I can mention here, dy minus 6 times dx is equal 0. Now just integrating it, so what I will get, so this is the y minus 6x is equal integrating constant c. So I can say this is the y minus 6x minus c is equal 0. And this is what exactly our f1 of x, y, z or x, y, c is equal y minus 6x minus c is equal 0. And similarly, we can find for p minus 3 is equal 0. So let us write p is equal dy by dx minus 3 is equal 0. So this can be written as dy minus 3 dx is equal 0. Now, whenever we integrate it, so what I will get, so it is clear that y minus 3x is equal, that is c. So from this, what I can say, y minus 3x minus 6 is equal 0. And here, if I said this is the f2, so I will have f2 of x, y, c is equal y minus 3x minus c is equal 0. So therefore, it's general solution. So therefore, general solution is, general solution is f1 x y c into f2 of x y c equal to 0. So let us write f1. F1 is nothing but y minus 6 x minus 6 and y minus 3 x minus c is equal 0. And this is your final answer. Let us see the another question. Solve x square p square plus xyp minus 6y square is equal 0. Here we want to solve this question solvable for p. So in that case, what we can, so first write it x square p square plus xyp minus 6y square is equal 0. This is the given equation number 1. Now we can factorize it. So for that, first we have to do the product of first and last, and we can split middle one term, so that the product of that middle one term, should be what exactly? First and last. So here we can see that the xp will be the common. So we have xp plus 3y minus 2y is common. So we have xp plus 3y is equal 0. So both the term has the common, that is the xp plus 3y, and the second, that is the xp minus 2y is equal 0. What does it mean by this? Means that first factor will be 0, otherwise second factor will be 0. So here you can see that the xp, but p is nothing but dy by dx plus 3y is equal 0. Now you can write as a separable form. So dy by y, just take y on the left hand side, and here 3 is there, dx by x, that also you can write. Now you need to integrate it. So what you will get? Ln y plus 3 ln x is equal ln c, because we can assume that arbitrary constant c, that is the ln c. So here what we can have, this is ln y plus this is the ln x raised to 3 is equal ln c. So what does it mean by that? According to the property of the logarithm function, ln y into x raised to 3 is equal ln c, and whenever we take the square exponents on the both the side, so we will have y x raised to cube is equal c. So whenever, if I assume that f1 of x y c, so what I will get, this is the y x cube minus c is equal 0. So this is our first solution. What about the second? So let me write here. So this is the xp minus 2y is equal 0. So here p is nothing but a dy by dx, and minus 2y is there. Now we can write that the dy by y minus 2 times dx by x. So from this we can have, this is the, after integrating it, we will have ln y minus, and this is the 2 times ln x is equal ln c. So from this we can write that the ln y minus ln x square is equal ln c. But here according to the formula of the logarithm function, we can write the ln y divided by x square is equal ln c, and from this, whenever I take the ln on the both sides, so y divided by x square is equal c. If I call it, this is the f2 of x y c, so it will be what, y minus c x square, because this can be written as what, y minus c x square equal to 0, and this is what, our f2. So our general solution will be what? So therefore, general solution will be what? F1 of x, y, c into F2 of x, y, c equal to 0. And that will be the final answer. So here F1 is nothing but y, x cube minus c, and F2 is nothing but y minus c, x square equal to 0. And that will be the final answer. So in this video, we have discussed about that the whenever we have that the first order and higher degree ordinary differential equation is there, and if it is solvable for P, then you can do. Thank you.